Let's talk about President Biden's priorities versus the media's priorities versus the public's priorities. Should they be aligned? Is the White House press corps pressing Biden on the American people's top concerns? And if not, why not? Those questions were brought into stark relief when everyone heard their questions, there's the White House press corps, at Thursday's presidential press conference. The press focused so many questions on immigration and on the filibuster, and there was really widespread criticism of the performance of the journalists in the room, specifically on how their questions ignored problems that Americans really clearly care about. Here's the data from Pew Research earlier this year, showing that front and center on Americans' minds are issues like the economy, the pandemic, unemployment, the scourge of terrorism, and healthcare. So are White House reporters out of sync with the country? I mean, individually, of course, there are outstanding reporters on the beat with lots of great questions. Collectively, though, there were zero questions asked about the pandemic on Thursday. And as you can see here, a former Obama spokesman called that a ridiculous failure by the press. Overall, 10 reporters were called on. Obviously, lots of others had lots of other questions they wanted to ask. And the press corps doesn't coordinate questions ahead of time. So it's not like there was a single person to blame for any of the missteps or the things that were missing from the press conference. But nevertheless, the lack of questions about the pandemic and the economy was a real shock. This infectious disease doctor told the Washington Post she was almost on the floor, so stunned by the oversight. And this tension extends beyond the press conference. It goes to the overall coverage of the new president and his agenda. From the right, there's obviously nonstop criticism of both Biden and the media, no surprises there. But lately, there's more and more criticism of the media's priorities from progressives and from moderates. There's a perception that Republicans are setting the narrative about the border, for example, and that Biden's getting more questions about the border than the economy as a result. Ted Cruz there. Now, obviously, the immigration situation is serious, but this Pelosi aide presumed the reporters didn't ask about the COVID relief law because it's popular. She said, because it's popular, it didn't come up. And as Esquire put it, the presser was a reminder for the press to think about who they represent. By all means, the writer said, challenge the president, but on behalf of Americans who are voiceless. Is that where the press is falling down? Why are there so many critiques of Biden coverage right now? Are reporters missing the big picture and the historic nature of Biden's agenda? And if so, why? We're going to speak with press corps insiders and outsiders. ABC's chief Washington correspondent, John Carl, is standing by. But first, two liberal critics of the press corps, starting with Amanda Marcotte. She's a politics writer for Salon and the author of Troll Nation. And Greg Sargent, opinion columnist for The Washington Post, who writes the Plumline blog. He's the author of An Uncivil War. Amanda, you first. What went wrong at Thursday's press conference?
I mean, I think you touched on a lot of it. After weeks of the press corps demanding this press conference, they asked Biden questions about immigration. They asked him if he's going to run in 2024, and they did not ask questions about the sort of things that the American public wants to know about, mainly the pandemic, when it's going to be over, what steps are being taken, how progress is on that, which is what Biden said that he's focused on. It was extremely frustrating because I think that was the information that most of us want the most, and it didn't even come up.
Greg, why did it not come up, you think?
Well, I'd like to go to something you said earlier, which just really, I think, hasn't gotten nearly the attention it deserves, which is that Republicans are setting the agenda on immigration. The press conference was a perfect example of that. The questions, and there's nothing wrong with asking questions about immigration, to be clear. They should be asking about that. But a number of the questions accepted the tacit right-wing frame that a lot of migrants seeking asylum here is inherently a bad thing. Look, there are serious challenges at the border, but they're management ones. The crisis is not the fact that lots and lots of people are seeking asylum. The crisis is what's happening in Central America, what's happening to the migrants themselves, and our failure to adequately manage the effort by these people to seek, exercise their legal right to apply for asylum. Yet in media discussions, all of that is just erased, and all we get is you're seeing a crisis at the border born of large numbers of people trying to apply, and that just ends up distorting the debate and misinforming people.
And now the new Fox narrative is, when will Biden go to the border? Why hasn't he gone there yet? Why isn't he there right now? We're going to hear that every day, by the way, until he takes the trip. That is how right-wing narratives trickle into the rest of the press, and they divert attention. Amanda, what are the broader complaints from the left about coverage of Biden thus far?
I mean, I think one of the biggest problems is exactly what Greg said, which is that the right sets the agenda. They decide that there's a border crisis and they don't want to look into the reasons for it. But more importantly,
but is that Democrats' fault? But is that Democrats' fault, Amanda? They passed this giant bill on a weekend, right? And then Biden went out and held a few press events, trying to get attention for it. But isn't it their fault if they're not working harder to get attention for their priorities?
I mean, I think, you know, the Democrats could always be doing more. They really could, obviously. But I think one of the complaints that the press has is that all these micromanaged presidential photo op situations are happening instead of press conferences. And one of the reasons is Biden knows that if he has a press conference, it's going to be a bunch of questions that are basically from the right-wing agenda that are not about what the American people want. And so, of course, he's going to just do more photo ops and really micromanaged events.
That's interesting. Greg, what are the left's frustrations with media coverage right now?
Well, I think one of the very big ones concerns the war on voting we're seeing across the country from Republicans. There's a huge wave of new voter suppression efforts underway in states. And almost uniformly, the way the press covers this is as a quote-unquote partisan battle. Right? As if there's an equivalence on one side between making it as hard to vote wherever possible, based on zero public rationale of any kind and based on the lie that the election was stolen from Trump, and on the other side, trying to make it as easy to vote as possible. There isn't a midpoint between a fireman and an arsonist, as a clever person remarked on Twitter. And this debate is just constantly distorted as nothing more than two parties equivalently trying to game the system for partisan advantage. But the deep moral and substantive differences between the parties on the underlying issue, should we make it harder to vote based on lies, or should we make it easier to vote so that more people can participate, is just always erased.
And Amanda, do you feel the press has not learned from the Trump years? Are they trying to be performatively tough on Biden in a bid to appear fair in the wake of Trump, when, of course, Trump was such an abnormality, such a liar, that there's no equivalency between the two?
Yeah, I mean, I think the problem isn't being tough on Biden, right? The problem is mistaking coming at Biden with right-wing talking points, often which are based on lies or misinformation, as if that was being tough on Biden. I think there's a lot of things that people actually want to ask President Biden, and it's not being asked because instead we're getting Fox News setting the agenda on immigration and on other subjects like that. I think that there is a way to be tough that actually gets us real answers to the questions that most of us actually have.
I love the way the Esquire story put it. Give voice to the voiceless. That's the opportunity when you're in front of the president. Let's help those folks. And by the way, some of the reporters did that about immigration. I loved when Cecilia Vega at ABC said, you know, I was just at the border talking to these kids. Let me tell you what I heard, Mr. President. Thought that was powerful. Amanda, Greg, thank you both. Now let's hear from someone who's logged hundreds of hours at White House Q&As, ABC's Jonathan Carl, the author of Front Row at the Trump Show, which is back on the bestseller list this week, now that it's out in paperback. So, John, thanks for being on. You were, of course, chief White House correspondent in the Trump years. Now, I just mentioned Cecilia Vega is at the briefing, was at the press conference on Thursday asking questions. There's been so much criticism of these 10 reporters for what they asked and what they didn't ask. How do you see it?
Well, look, you can always second guess the questions that are asked. I mean, I've been in there many times under four different presidents at press conferences. And, you know, you go in there with a list of questions. One of the big things for me when I would go into a press conference is, you know, I would have my, you know, one or two, I really want to do this question. But I was always, you know, worried that, you know, depending on when you're called on, those questions could be asked. So I always went in with a long list. You know, in case the question had already been asked to hit a different subject. There's never a shortage of things to ask a president about. Watching from home, I would have liked to have seen, more questions, certainly questions on COVID. But there were good questions asked. And, you know, I mean, you pointed to Cecilia Vega. I think that's incredibly valuable. That is not right-wing talking points. Cecilia had just been at the border. She had just talked to migrants who had come over, including some that said point blank that they had come because they thought that they would have better treatment now that Joe Biden was president. That's a legitimate question to put to the president. And I thought that his answer was one of the more interesting moments in that press conference.